Today I've come across a job where I have to fix the insulation in a trailer, a mobile home trailer. Last week I was over here fixing the customer's hot water heater. It was leaking into the floor and ruining the floor. So we took care of that. And today we are here to fix the insulation damage. So I'm going to give you guys a view of what kind of room we actually have under here to work with. And then I'll show you step by step how we're going to fix it. And maybe you guys like this technique, maybe you won't, and you can try it out for yourself. Okay, so here's a view going inside of the crawl. It's pretty tight in here. There's about 14 inches for me to work with underneath the some of these carrying steels, and here's the plumbing issue. Wow. They evidently had a fire here. Well, we're gonna try and straighten out all this mess, including fixing up that ductwork, that main duct that's in there. We're gonna straighten this out. So as soon as I get some of this insulation cleared out of here, ladies and gentlemen, I will show you what it looks like. Hopefully I can get it a little more cleaned out and you'll be able to see. There's just no room in here to really work, and this ought to be fun. So there it is, the underneath. Okay, so here we are under here, day number two. Cleaned out all the insulation from the base here, and all the rotted out insulation where the fire was at, and all wet from coming. And I have put screws in all the ends here for these joists. And I'm going to stitch this up with the blanket of insulation. See, it's pretty tight in here. This is my feet. Okay. You can see the mess now. Yeah, it's pretty tight in here. No. There you have it. I'll show it to you after I bring the insulation blanket in that I made. Okay, well, here is the little insulation blanket that I've made. It's I was going to use Tyvek under there to be more rugged of a membrane, but it's expensive. And so to save just a homeowner here a couple of bucks, we've used an old tarp here, and I've construction adhesive the bats of insulation to the plastic so I can drag it under there. Right now I'm going to cut this piece into a 7-footer, and because it's kind of fluffy, we've used R19 here as opposed to R13, which is what was under there, and this is almost 6 inches stuff, so this area is 8x14 here. So we're going to cut this in half, and so that I can seam it just on one side of one of the cross braces inside the trailer, and then we'll stitch it up with the wire and the screws that I hung in the joists there. I plan on stitching it sort of like a shoelace boot, X to X, to tighten it up in there against the joists and to encapsulate the plumbing and the heating trunk tubing. So there you have it, and I'll show you some more of this after I drag some of that in there. Yeah, it's a little dark, but there it is. The first section put in there, R19, 6.5-inch insulation. The bats glued down to the tarp. I glued them on there last night with construction adhesive. And then I drag rolled up the tarp, put the insulation in it, and dragged it in here. And then unfurled it and wired it with the this roll of wire that I have down here on the ground. And as you can see, the bag method here seems to be working out, as far as I'm concerned, far superior to trying to staple bats in bays, just because there's no way. The original construction had this same sort of thing. They call it an insulation blanket that was laid down here, and I'm just trying to reproduce it. But we're using a little bit bigger, a little bit better R-value material than they used back then, and I was trying to seal it up as tight as possible. There you have it. There's the first section put in.